courtesy, these are some of the slides which were shared by Walter Moon. Visual inspection, then identification of a structural distresses. There are some non-destructive testing methods available like ground penetration radar, impact echo, impulse response, half cell potentiometer, periscope. So, like in modern days, when we go to doctor, he prescribes certain tests to be carried out, like doing X-ray for any defects in the bones, or some 3D echo, or some other test, which are a non-destructive test when we compare it with the breach test. So from ground penetration radar, we can find out the condition of reinforcement as well as the position of reinforced part. There are certain methods like short-term inspection method and long-term monitoring method. In short-term method, for certain period, like a 1 week's time, we have to provide some sensors to the breach and monitor certain aspects like deflection of breach, deflection of arch and various spans, then expansion and contraction of various girders for a shorter period of say 8 days or 10 days. And on that basis we can find out what was the expansion considered while designing the breach and what is the actual expansion during the life of the breach. These are some sensors provided and strain gauges. For finding out the distresses in arch bridges, if we provide a sensor at these three locations, then we can find out the distresses or displacement when a traffic is flying on the road. Then data analysis and recommendations. Once we get this data of some displacement or the measurements of various aspects, then we can analyze that data and then recommend the type of repairs required for that bridge. These are some methods suggested for rehabilitation of bridges. The typical example is seeping of water, then rusting of reinforcement, and then spalling of concrete and deterioration of bridge. These are some photographs of replacement of expansion joints. This is a photograph of removing a bearing and replacement. So for removing bearing, we need to support the jacks which are provided for lifting the deck slab. For lifting this deck slab, we need to provide a jack in such a way that when we operate the manifold, all the jacks should be raised at the same time. Otherwise, because of this operation of jacks, there are chances that the distress gets introduced in the bridges. Therefore, this is a specific requirement that all the jacks should be operated from the same manifold. Then concrete jacketing. This is another method of removal. In this method, if the steel is rusted, then we should remove the loose cover and the material which is loose, and then clean the steel reinforcement. If needed, add some additional reinforcement, and then this jacketing process and connecting process is done. Then this is a new method. Carbon wrapping, these are steps to be carried out while doing concrete repairs. There are certain methods, like for removing the vegetation on the bridge, we just cut those small trees on the bridge, but the roots remains there and again it sprouts. So there is one method, this is not written anywhere, but if we add hing, hing is asafoetida and lime powder mixed together, and if we put that on the roots get burned inside the component. For avoiding the scoring of foundations, we need to put a scoring measure by putting these garlanding blocks. For supporting this arch, we have provided a new reinforced arch below the existing arch. This is strengthening of arch. This is a typical example of strengthening of arch. This is masonry arch supported with a concrete arch. These are joints. This is a bridge near Nashik. This was the Savitri bridge. These are some photographs of distress. Just I want to share for the bridges, like balance cantilever bridges, the expansion joints are like this. How to find out if there is any distress in the bridge? We can see the railing provided for this bridge. There is a gap between the top level of these two rails. This clearly shows there is a sag of certain centimeters in this bridge. So how these bridges are rehabilitated? Here we can see there is a difference in this. So this span has sagged. These are methods used for rehabilitation of box girders or balance cantilever bridges. For these bridges, we provide pre-stressing. So these are the pre-stressing cables provided inside the box for stressing these bridges and putting them back in the original position. These are the photographs taken at Ganga Bridge at Patna. For these balance cantilever bridges, at the central portion, a hinge was provided, but at some places, because of this, when a vehicle passes over it, because of the length, it just strikes on this and gives a typical sound, because and these are provided to avoid deflection in the bridge. However, at some places they remove this component. Some of the bridges we constructed recently in Pimpri Chinchwad and Pune area. This is a suspension bridge at Bhopal. This is Narmada Bridge, Khandwa. This is Kudalwadi Junction. This is behind the telco. This is a typical example. This level and this side level, there is a drop of 7.5 meters in 75 meters. So we have provided this rotary and approaches on various sides. These are recently completed bridges. Harris Bridge, which connects Pimpri Chinchwad and Pune. We constructed two separate bridges, and now rehabilitation of the old masonry bridge is in progress. This is KSB Junction. We know KSB Junction was very congested junction. So we provided two separate flyovers, and DRTS is at grade and two separate grade separator at the same location. This is Karvinagar flyover, Cummins College. This is Sadar Road, Dhankawadi Flyover. This is Kalewadi Flyover. We have used various methods of construction for these bridges. Like in this bridge, we have used precast pre-stress girders and a stitching at the junction. So we have provided only two bearings, and on two bearings there are three girders. And the earlier bridges we have provided a box girder, at some places portal frame. This is Empire State Flyover, constructed recently, opened recently for traffic. This is 1.6 km long bridge here in PCMC, 3 plus 3, 6 lanes, constructed in a segmental type of construction. This crosses river, then Pune-Mumbai railway line and Pune-Mumbai old national highway. This is a road recently constructed, Pune to Alandi Road, 61 meter wide road. This is Kalewadi Bhatta to Devu Alandi Road, 45 meter wide road. This is our office and our resources available. Thank you so much. Just I want to tell you, this was a very brief introduction about the subject of bridge and inspection of bridges. And as mentioned by Mr. Deepak Jodhavar, there are a lot of opportunities available in the field of bridge construction. Lot of material is available on website, this internet. But one has to think very specifically on a subject of bridge. Opportunities like construction of new bridges, then design of new bridges, innovative bridges, these are opportunities for the new projects. Similarly, for rehabilitation of old bridges also, there are so many opportunities available across the India, because the bridges constructed during British era are now slowly getting deteriorated because of non-maintenance. For any bridge, maintenance is a very important activity which should be taken care by the client or the owner of the bridge. In our case, PWD Govt of Maharashtra is owner of most of the bridges across Maharashtra. They have their method, they have their staff inspecting those bridges. They have their typical tabular forms to be filled, some forms to be filled before monsoon, some forms to be filled after monsoon. So in nutshell, inspection of bridge is a very key point in maintenance of bridges. So I wish you all very best for your future. Thank you very much.